Well, hello, students.
You know, there's nothing like good old-fashioned maple syrup on your pancakes. I have a friend in the neighborhood who every year collects the sap from maple trees, and he makes his own syrup. Mm-mm, that's good stuff. Let's take a look, shall we? Let's just review a couple of things. First of all, leaves are the food factories. The trees don't need them in the winter time, but these are what do photosynthesis. The tree is getting water up through the roots, up to the leaves, carbon dioxide through the stomata. It's putting those together, six of these plus six of these, to make one of these, a sugar molecule. And there's a lot of this, six of these left over, and that is oxygen. So the sap that Dan collected and he's making syrup from came from photosynthesis. Well, one of the things we should do is check on those branches that we put in water last week. Actually, it was about 5 days ago. So here they are, and I can start to see some changes happening here. Let's take a closer look. The red one is the red osier dogwood, and that's starting to open up. And those look like they're going to be leaves and flowers. This one is the Juneberry or Serviceberry, and a lot of these buds are opening up, and there's going to be quite a few leaves. I hope we'll have some flowers on that one too. It's a gorgeous spring day. Let's get outside. We're going to do some special things today. We're going to find fossils, and then I'll take you all the way out to school, and we'll look at the goldenrod gall fly larva. See how they're doing. Come on. So here I am on this beautiful day above the Mississippi River, and we're gonna go down a trail to a place where there's some sedimentary rocks, and those sedimentary rocks are gonna contain some fossils. And this layer in St. Paul is over 450 million years old. So there are so many fossils here that pretty much any one of these big gray rocks you pick up are going to have lots of fossils in them. None of them are spectacular, but just the sheer number is kind of amazing. There must have been some kind of event, like an earthquake, that caused a mudslide that was underwater in this shallow ocean, and it buried a lot of the living creatures, and their remains are found in this shale. There are brachiopods, which are a little bit like clams. There are things called crinoids, which it's really might be hard to see, but it's like a little circle thing here. And that's just part of a larger organism. Nice shell right here. And these can be broken up and worked out of the stone, surrounding stone. Here's a couple that I've worked out. looking at the goldenrod galls. There's a lot of them on the ground. They're kind of beaten down by the snow, and many of them are opened up. So that means some birds like chickadees or the woodpeckers have worked their way in and have eaten any of the little larvae that were inside. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna check to see where the larvae are at, find one that hasn't been pecked open, and see if it's a pupa or if it's still a larva. So if it's a pupa, that means that it's getting ready to become an adult fly. And what we'll do in a few weeks or maybe a month is take some of these, put them in a jar with a screen on top, and wait and see what emerges out of them. So we should be able to see the adult gall fly. All right, so here we go. Gonna open it up. Okay, number one. Ooh, definitely has a larva inside. So it's like a little bean. I'm gonna film this even though I may not put this in the movie, but some of you are really gonna want to see me show that these are edible. Okay, so here we go. Slightly nutty, but not too much flavor. So I noticed when I ate one in the fall, it actually was sweeter. So it probably had more of the chemical in it that is like the antifreeze that keeps it from freezing. Maybe this time of the year, maybe a lot of that has been used up or converted to something else, or maybe used as food. I'm not sure, but it definitely wasn't as sweet. So there's a little scientific experiment, controlled experiment. You taste the larva in the fall, wait till spring, taste them again, do a comparison. It's a little tricky to do because you don't have them at the same times to do it based on memory, I guess.
Until next time, bye-bye. Thank you.